Dolly Parton, welcome to the Sunday Project and the official announcement that 9 to 5 the musical is coming to Australia, and I have to say this is exactly the sort of good news we all need right now.
Well, I'm very excited about that. We're actually going to premiere in Sydney in 2022. We've kind of had to take off because of COVID and we missed a while, but now we're back and we're very excited to come back to Australia.
Now, 9 to 5 is, of course, about a group of female office workers, yourself, Jane Fonda, and Lily Tomlin. And the amazing thing about that movie is it was 40 years ago, and yet the themes that it talks about are still just as relevant today. Why do you think that is?
I think people still relate to the workplace. We all have to work under a boss for the most part. So I think a lot of the fun is how we treat the boss and kind of do it in a tongue-in-cheek sort of thing. But also making our point, I'm no different than anybody else being a girl. I've certainly had my share of being hit on and all that. But, you know, to me, I was a little luckier than some. I had a chance to get away from all that and kind of stand on my own. But I love being able to portray other people's feelings and know how they do feel. So I really was very honored to get to be part of that whole thing.
There is a very strong women's rights theme behind the movie. Given that, would you call yourself a feminist?
Well, I'm very feminine. But I actually, I don't know that I'd say that I'm a feminist, but I do believe in that women should be treated with great respect. I think that shouldn't matter whether you're male or female. If you do a job, you should be recognized for it and you should be paid for it. So I'm always one of those people. I'm always for the underdog, no matter what that story is or what that situation may be.
It's also a true story from my childhood.
Being an underdog is something Dolly can relate to. She was raised in a one-room cabin in the Smoky Mountains of Tennessee with 11 brothers and sisters.
And I didn't have a coat, and it was way down in the fall.
The Partons didn't have much money, but Dolly was surrounded by music from the moment she entered the world.
She made my coat of many colors.
Well, I was born, as my grandpa said, I came out singing in the key of D, crying in the key of D, as my grandpa said. But music was a very big part of my family. My mother's people were very musical. My grandpa was a preacher. I learned to sing in church, but he was also very musical. He played the piano at church, and so I just always loved playing the guitar mostly. But I saw early on that this was what I wanted to do and what I wanted my life's work to be.
One of the highest points of Dolly's life's work came almost 50 years ago, when, in the one day, she wrote two of the greatest songs in history, I Will Always Love You and the infamous Jolene.
Jolene, 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 I'm begging of you, please don't take my...
Half a century on, and it's still one of the most celebrated and covered songs of all time.
Well, that little song has been the most recorded song I've ever written, even beyond I Will Always Love You and a lot of the other songs, but it's the one that's been most recorded through the years all over the world. Somebody has a version of Jolene.
Jolene, Jolene, Jolene.
Because you can.
Dolly lent the song and her star power to the global fight against the COVID pandemic.
Vaccine, vaccine, I'm begging of you, please don't hesitate.
She even donated $1 million to the research team that created the Moderna vaccine.
I just saw at the start that this was going to be a bad thing. I didn't know how bad it was going to be, but I just kind of felt led to do something to help support whatever cure they could find. That's when we're all just panicking. So I felt really led to do it, and I'm really glad that I was just a small part of that, but I was happy when I could get my own Moderna shots.
One of your most loved songs is Islands in the Stream with Kenny Rogers. What are your memories of working with Kenny?
Well, working with Kenny Rogers has been one of the greatest joys of my life. And singing Islands in the Stream with Kenny, that was one of the biggest duets of all time, still is.
Islands in the Stream, that is what we are.
To end the world, and we rely on each other.
when you start that song, everybody just goes crazy, and everybody knows every word, and they sing along, you know, with it. But it's a great feeling through the years to have songs that are so singable and things that people love, and they feel like they're part of you and part of it. And that's why we do it, to, you know, to kind of bring joy and kind of, you know, inspire people to get out and have fun.
You have certainly done that. That brings me to Dolly the Playboy Bunny. You, of course, appeared in a Playboy Bunny suit for that magazine way back in 1978. And recently, you recreated that image for your husband, Carl.
In the first one, say, remember this? I was kind of a little butterball in that one. Well, I'm string cheese now. But he'll probably think I'm cream cheese, I hope.
My husband has not been feeling well for quite a while, and I do anything that I can to make him, you know, feel better and lift his spirits and everything. And he's always thought I was beautiful.
He still thinks I'm a hot chick after 57 years, and I'm not going to try to talk him out of that. And I hope he agrees. What do you think?
But a lot of people got a kick out of that, so, and he did for sure.
Dolly, can we talk about your charity, Dolly's Imagination Library? Where did the idea for that come from?
Well, I can say that I'm as proud of the Imagination Library as anything I've ever done in my entire life, and I'm proud to be called the Book Lady.
Well, hello, it's Dolly, the Book Lady. I'm going to read you a special story today.
It actually started from a very serious place. My own father, bless his heart, was a great, brilliant man, but he didn't get a chance to go to school, so Daddy couldn't read and write, and it always troubled him. He was a little bit always embarrassed about that, so I started the little program for my home county with my dad because I wanted him to feel part of it. They put it all over Tennessee, and now worldwide we've given away like 160 million books to children. So I'm very, very proud of that, and thanks for asking about it. And my dad got to live long enough to see it doing so well, and he took great pride in that, and I took great pride in knowing that I had done something good not only for the kids but for my daddy.
What an amazing legacy in your father's name, and what an incredible gift that you've given to so many children over the years. Dolly, it is such a treat to chat to you. Congratulations on the musical, and we can't wait to see it here in Australia.
9 to 5, the musical's coming to Australia. Go see it. Thank you. Goodbye.